is kind of on a borderline, but it's also kind of straightforward. So we have a footwear which is imported on December 1st, 2001, and so we have 12/29/2109. This is day of importation. So that's relevant, right? With entry summary filed on January 4th, on entry number as such so and so. At the time of entry summary, footwear is entered under HTSUS duty free, and the import specialist, he did a review and he reclassified it, raising the bar to 37.5%. And that was done on April 10th, 2010. So we have reclassification and probably followed by the liquidation on April 30th. So duty goes up on April 10th. So of course we know that if duty goes up on April 10th, this is the date of determination, but it goes all the way back to the date of entry, right? To the January 4th, this is when the duties begin to accumulate, because that's when the liability arises from the date of entry. The entry liquidates with changes on April, the filing of entry summary, CBP form 7501. So the entry liquidates with changes, and the importer of record receives the bill for additional duties due. The importer completes a review and determines that NAFTA applies. And the question is, when can they file a duty refund claim? Meaning that when is the last day where they can go to customs and say, customs, we do not owe any duties because as you can see, the HTS number is a little different, but even though it's duty-free, this can also be duty-free because we have NAFTA application, we have free trade agreement, the general column rate is not applicable, we want special column rate. Now, all right, so we know it's the day of importation, which is 12/21/2009. It's 1 year after, so it will be 12/22/2010. That would be the last day when they can file. So which of the following days must be a valid claim be filed to receive a refund for duties? We have July 4th, 2010. Well, July 4th, 2010, I cannot associate it with anything. Perhaps 90-day rule, but 90-day rule is out of question. December 21st, that's a close one to this one. It's right on the border, though, right? But it's good enough. If you file it by December 21st, 2010, then you're good. January 4th, 2011, you are too late for that. And we're talking about the entry date, right? Notice, it's not the date of entry, right? It must be the date of importation for the purposes of the 1520D claim. And April 30th, well, April 30th, we have the liquidation date, right? And by then, it's too late to file a protest. It's too late to file a post-importation duty refund claim. So that one is obviously incorrect. And October 30th, 2011, well, I cannot even think why would they put October 30th, 2011 on the spreadsheet, because I cannot see any association here. It is incorrect. As you analyze this question, please note that the call-up question, by which of the following dates must be a valid NAFTA claim is filed. By which is really the key point here, because if you file it on July 4th, 2010, it will be still within the time limit, right? As well as you file it by December. So potentially A, by looking at how the question is framed, also feels within the bill, but by which they really imply when is the last day due. However, note it's 1 year from the date of importation. See, so this is one of the caveats here, one of the analysis. So customs is really implying we're looking for the very latest date, and latest date here is December 21, notwithstanding the fact that that this fits within, this takes that first day of importation. Notice, customs examiners, when they applied this rule, they didn't take that from requirement from the statute. They included that one day in the answer choice. Sometimes they do that, sometimes they do not. It's just a matter of who writes the exam. But we must, as we study for the exam, we must be aware that by which implies the very latest one that is available within the last answer choice, the presented answer choice. And under the best answer rule, which is the rule that you apply to the exam, the answer that fits best all available answer choices, because examiners keep on insisting that all of this, even though they give sometimes two answer choices, sometimes they give credit to all, they continue to insist that the question is designed to have a single best answer, even though they change their mind sometimes. So December 21st, 2010 is the best answer for this particular question.